Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back. Today we'll discuss some few programming exercise. I have taken few example from looping, one example from array. So let us start. One program that is normally helping us to create many logic, we have to accept one number, okay? For example, I have this as one number, right? Possible programs are: this is my number, what is the maximum digit in that given number, right? So in this example it is 9. Then find the summation of the digits. So 5 plus 4 plus 8 plus 9, this is the summation of the digits. Then minimum digit, we have 4. And last possible program, reverse, that is 9845. For all these kind of programs, basic logic that may remain same for all is, I have to first 5, 4, 8, 9, I have to first separate out individual digits, right? And then only I can go with the possible options that I want to do, right? So basic logic behind this is how to separate out this individual digits. If this is my number n, right, what I can do to separate out? N modulo 10. What is this modulo operator? It gives me remainder. What do I mean by that? If this is my 8, 9, if this is my number, I am performing division operation, right? 10 5s are 50, I'll get 4. 10 4s are 40, I'll get 8, 89, 8s are, so I will get 9. So 9 is the remainder that I'm going to get, remainder, right? So modulo operation will give me the remainder. So when I am separating out, that is remainder is equal to n modulo 10, it will give me 9, right? Now next step is, I want to separate out next digit, but before that, I should make this number as 5489. 5489 should be made as 548, right? First step, again, I have to find the remainder. So I will get first step as 9, right? Now 9 is already known to us, matlab that is already removed. So now your remaining number is 548. What is the next step? I want to extract next digit, that is 8. So again I have to perform remainder operation. But how to make this number 5489 from 5489 to 548? So what is the next step? N equal to n by 10. Integer division. So I will get 5489. It is integer division. Both these are integers. So I will get 548. Right? Now my number has reduced to 3 digit. Now this 2 steps I am going to perform. How many times? As many times my digits are there with me. First time, second, third, and fourth is my last digit that will be remaining. Now this kind of programs which are requiring repeatedly the same task, we use the concept of loop, right? Now how the loop can be formed? How to form the loop? Yes, while number remains greater than 0, right? R equal to n modulo 10, right? N equal to n by 10, okay? But what is our program? Are we just going to extract the digit and finish it off like this? No. What is our program? First program is to find the maximum digit, right? So what I can do, I can take one variable as max, initialize it with some zero value, right? With zero value. Okay. Now I am extracting digit in R, right? So I can add one line over here if I want to find maximum digit, right? So if R is greater than max, I need to change max. Next step is max is equal to R. Fine? Once again, what is my problem? I want to find the maximum digit in a given number, right? So my number, for example, it is 4-digit number 5489, right? So I will extract individual digit and compare it with existing max. My initial value of max is 0. Then I will extract first rightmost digit by using r equal to n modulo 10. When I use this, what happens? I am able to extract the digit, right? It gives me remainder. So remainder is my digit, right? I will compare this, whatever I have got, with the existing max. अगर max की value r से छोटी है, that means कि हमें उसको replace करना पड़ेगा, right? तो ये step होने के बाद आप क्या करेंगे? अब मुझे 5489 पूरा number नहीं चाहिए, अब मुझे सिर्फ 548 चाहिए. तो उसके लिए next step क्या होगा आपका? N equal to n by 10, right? So these steps I'm going to repeat till where? So let us trace 5489. First time I got 9, right? So this step is over. Maximum digit के अंदर अभी 9 आ चुका है. Second step, यहां से वापस n greater than 0. अब मेरे पास क्या है? 548 है, right? 548 है, अंदर गया, condition is true. R is equal to n modulo 10. So what I will get? 8, right? So this condition is false, so it will not do the replacement. N is equal to 54. Again यहाँ पे गया, n greater than 0 है, अंदर गया, R equal to n modulo 10. So what is the value? 4. No need of replacing. N is equal to n by 10. So what value I will get? 5, right? 5 is greater than 0. Yes, R equal to n by 10, I will get 5, right? Again this turns out to be false, so no replacement. N is equal to n by 10, what value I will get? 5 by 10, I'll get 0, integer hai na. Now your condition comes out to be false, so you will come out of this loop. This is how you are going to extract the digit, and also you will check for the maximum value. In this example, 9 was maximum digit. For example, if I have 6, 9, 2, 4, then 4 first time, this if condition was not satisfied. It will be satisfied because max is equal to 0. So it will be satisfied, it will become 4. But second time it is 2, so it will not be satisfied. Third time it is 9, so it will be satisfied. And 4 times 6, so this will not be satisfied. So finally in max you will get the value as 9. So this logic can be used to find the maximum digit. Okay, the same logic, instead of writing this line, right, I can do the logic as I can have sum is equal to 0, right? Then I can do like this, sum is equal to sum plus r. This will help me to perform the summation of individual digit, right? After this line I should write this line. So second program is also clear, right? Summation is over. Agar minimum digit ka karna hai to same maximum ki jagah pe aap minimum kar dijiye aur yahan par less than kar dijiye to minimum ho jayega, right? Ab next step is how to do the reverse, right? To reverse ke liye pehle hame samajhna padega. Reverse is equal to 0. Try to make the formula on your own, don't try to memorize anything. How to make the formula? Let us see that. Okay, so agar main reverse into r aisa kuch banati hu to kuch hota hai nahi ho raha hai. Then reverse into 10, reverse into 10 plus r. Okay, let us see what I have to write here, that we have to decide. Okay, reverse initial value is 0, right? Initial into 10, so 0 into 10 I'll get 0 plus r. Pahli value kya thi meri? 9 for this example, right? So I'll get here 9, right? Here if I write reverse, so reverse is equal to 9. Okay, now next value I'm getting is 8 for r. So now 9 into 10 gives me 90 plus what is the value of this? So 98, I will get 98, right? So reverse is equal to 98. So reverse karne ke liye 98 hua, to 98 ho gaya. Then mujhe kya karna hai? Fir se 98 into 10, I will get 980. Reverse r ki value kya mili mujhe? 4 mili. So plus 4, 984 I will get. So it is going proper, 984. Then 984 into 10, I will get 9840 plus R, that is 5. So 9845 will be my reverse. I hope this is clear. I will explain once again. I can assume reverse is equal to 0 initially. Now I want to make some formula which helps me to reverse this digits, right? So I can write like this: reverse is equal to reverse into 10 plus R. What is R? यहां से जो आपको R की वैल्यू मिलती है वो आप देख सकते हो, R की वैल्यू यहां से आपको मिलेगी, इंडिविजुअल डिजिट मिलेंगे आपको, राइट? तो आपने क्या किया यहां पर, 0 into 10, I will get 0 plus R. What is the value of R? In this case, it is 9 for the first step, right? These steps I have to incorporate in this loop, right? Then next time, reverse is now having value 9. So 9 into 10, new R is 8, so it becomes 90 plus 8, right? So I will get as 98, right? This way you are going to execute the step. So with this example, you are able to solve problems like finding the maximum digit in a given integer. Now see, in this kind of problems, if you are having 4-digit number, right? If you are having 5-digit number, if you are having 6-digit number, then simple integer you have to take as a data type, or you have to take long integer, that you must decide. Okay? Then you can also do the summation, you can find the minimum digit, you can find the reverse number. This basic logic helps you to do all this kind of operations. Right? So let us see one example. Here I have taken long integer, R for remainder, max is equal to 0, number and T. T I am going to store my initial number. I am taking number, then T mein maine initial jo number dala hai usko store kar diya hai. Now the same logic which I discuss, NO greater than 0, R is equal to NO modulo 10. If max is less than R, what is the initial value of max? 0, right? Then I should interchange the value. So max is equal to R, right? I should change the value. NO is equal to NO by 10. Then finally, I'll be able to print the maximum. Let us see when it is executed. The number is entered as 65473. Maximum digit is 7. Right? This was a program to display the maximum digit in a given number. Right? Now, I have taken it as long integer because I want to give more than 4 digit. As you know, integer will have 3 to that range. Okay? So you cannot use more than that. I hope this is clear. Now, next is reversing a given number. Here, reverse equal to 0 has been accepted. It is entering the number. Right, I am saving the number in T so that I can display it later on, because NO will keep on changing. While NO greater than 0, R is equal to NO modulo 10. So I will get the remainder. Right, reverse is equal to reverse into 10 as I explained here plus R. NO is equal to NO by 10. So NO will keep on changing each time this loop is executed. So we need to store that. Right. Now in this program only, we can also check for palindrome, right? So let us first execute without that portion. What happens? Four, five, seven, six is my reverse, right? Now, what happens when I want to check for palindrome? What do I mean by palindrome number? If my number is 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, right? This is my number. If I am reading from this side as well as from this side, the number turns out to be same. So what is the logic I can apply? Just accept the number, reverse it using the logic we have already developed over here, right? And compare both this number. Right, you have reverse number in REV and initial number I have stored in T. So you can just compare these two by using if condition. If both are same, that means your number is palindrome. I hope you know what is palindrome number. When you read your number from left side as well as from right side, it turns out to be same. So this logic has been incorporated in the program. Just have a look. Okay. In this part you can see if t is equal to reverse, right, you can print that it is palindrome. If not, then it is not palindrome. I hope this program is clear. Okay. Now let us take simple program of factorial number, because we are discussing some loop category programs. What do I mean by factorial of any number? 5 factorial. कैसे कैलकुलेट करते हैं हम मैथमेटिकली? 5 इंटू 4 इंटू 3 इंटू 2 इंटू 1, राइट? इफ आई कॉल 5 एन ओ इक्वल टू 5, राइट? तो हमें इसका लॉजिक बनाना है. आप देख सकते हो कि एन ओ किप्स ऑन रिड्यूसिंग बाय 1, एंड बिकॉज इट इज मल्टीप्लीकेशन तो इनिशियल वैल्यू 0 नहीं ले सकते, अदरवाइज एवरीथिंग विल बिकम 0. सो आई कैन डू वन थिंग और वी कैन डू वन थिंग. फैक्ट इज इक्वल टू 1, राइट? Then fact is equal to fact into NO, right? So first time what happens? 1 into 5, because our NO is 5. So now your answer becomes 5 for fact. Now what you need to do, because it should go downwards, your N should keep on decreasing. I hope I'm clear. So aap kya karenge? NO minus minus. Hai na? Hum minus minus kar denge. To kya hoga? Ab N ki value decrease ho jayegi by 1. Now again you repeat the same task. Fact is equal to fact into NO. Previous value of fact was 5 into new value of NO is 4. So now it becomes 20. फिर से आप NO को minus minus कीजिए तो 3 हो गया. Fact 5 into 4 into 3, it is going as per the logic. लेकिन ये loop कब खत्म होनी चाहिए? जब तक आपका NO 1 नहीं हो जाता या it is greater than 0. Okay? So you will put a loop while NO is greater than 0. Just repeat this task. Okay? So I hope this logic is